Rhythmists, it's Mora's Modern Rhythmists, my favorite band, celebrating 25 years. Tonight, Mr. Dean Mora and Kerr Morrison and Mr. Damon Kirsch will present some of the favorite tunes of these past quarter century. But for now, please welcome Dean Mora and the Mora's Modern Rhythmists.
Thank you,
Dean. I'm going to let the stage to you, and I'm going to get out of here.
All right. Thank you, Mr. DeMille, and thank you also very much for attending our 25th anniversary show. My name is Dean Mora, and I can't believe we're still here, actually. That's wonderful. So it was, thank you. So it's actually, we wouldn't say that this is the exact 25th year, the 25th anniversary. Actually, our first concert was in the bustling metropolis of Moore Park, California, in November of 1994. Oh, yes, yes, so. However, today kicks off a whole year of celebrations, and you'll see some stuff on our Facebook site of old photos and stuff like that. It's like, oh my gosh, I need to get some work done. But we hope you enjoy our evening. The first number we're gonna play for you was actually the very first number we ever played, period. This is a tune from 1926 called Deep Henderson, and I hope we remember how it goes. Here we go. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Deep Henderson. I also want to note another anniversary, not as well remembered, but today, marks the 48th anniversary of the Sylmar earthquake. Yay! February 9th, 1971. Anyway, just a reminder, be prepared. All right. And now we're going to bring to the microphone Ms. Kerr Morrison. Now, Kerr has been with us since 1997. And when she was a tween. Yeah, that's it. Anyway, she's going to sing for us a Duke Ellington number called The Creole Love Call.
This one? Okay, the shorter one. Yes, I had to get a work permit to work with Dean back in the day. And if you believe that.
Kerr Morrison, singing Duke Ellington's Creole Love Call. She's going to sing another song for you, totally different in nature, and it's called Ain't That Too Bad.
This
it's a sort
words.
Of a...
This one has words.
This one has words, exactly. Yeah, sure, she can do a whoa, 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 whoa. Let's see what she does with words. All right.
Uh-oh. Pressure.
Wise men say there's just one way to heaven, but wise men may be wrong once in a while. 'Cause I'm on my way right now, and I realize somehow that the way I found is great, that's why I smile. Oh, I'm in love and I'm so glad, he's the sweetest boy I've had, and he loves me, ain't that too bad. I'm so short, he's so tall, he's just made for me, that's all, he's heavenly, ain't that too bad. He thinks that I'm just right in every bite and told me he was wealthy. What a break, for goodness sake, the man's both ripped and healthy. No one knows where he goes every night in dinner clothes, excepting me, ain't that too bad. Is it any wonder that I'm all excited? Is it any wonder that I wear a smile? I'm as happy as can be. Take a look at me and see. I found out what makes life really worthwhile.
Thank you very much, Care. Now we're going to do a song that we played on that very first concert, way back before the turn of the century. And this is a song from 1929, very kind of a standard now. This is the original version of Am I Blue?
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Am I blue? You're just coming after the eight bars. Yeah, I think so. Yeah. And now we'll bring to the microphone a gentleman who has been with the band since 2002. Yes, exactly, exactly. I think the band was performing for a promotional video for Disney, and this gentleman was brought on as one of the singers, and I said, hey, we have a band, this is a real band, and he said, I like to sing. And I said, well, maybe just for one or two gigs. Well, here we are. We're very glad he's here. How about a big hand for Damon Kirsch, singing for you? Again, started when he was a tween with the band, exactly. Who's gonna sing a song made popular by Maurice Chevalier? This is Louise.
Can it be true, someone like you could love me, Louise?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now Damon's gonna sing another song for you because you asked for more, Stephen. And here we go with a song from 1928, Love Me or Leave Me. And Damon will sing the chorus. It's Well, take both endings, and he'll sing the second chorus.
Okay.
And this is not the one we
me and let me be lonely. You won't believe me, but I love you only. I'd rather be lonely than happy with somebody else. You might find the nighttime the right time for kissing, but nighttime is my time for just reminiscing, regretting instead of forgetting with somebody else. There'll be no one. That someone is you. I intend to be independently blue. I want your love, but I don't want to borrow. To have it today and to give back tomorrow. For my love is your love, there's no love for nobody else.
Again, how about a hand for Damon Kirsch, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Way back when we did our first concert, we had 10 people on stage, of which one of them remains. the person who was here, who played our first concert, is our own Jeff Newdell. He is Musician Zero. And we're very glad that you're still with us. And all the rest of the guys kind of showed up like maybe the following year. So you're Musician One, but he's Musician Zero. But we also have another Musician Zero who's joining us for us. Oh, no. But before we bring him on, you guys, right? Yes. But before we bring that other, we're going to have Care and Damon sing for you a song by George and Ira Gershwin called Do, Do, Do.
remember the bliss of that wonderful kiss. I knew that a boy could never have more joy from any little miss.
I remember it quite. What a wonderful night.
Oh, how I'd adore it if you would encore it. Do, do, do what you done, done, done before, baby. Do, do, do what I do, do, do adore, baby. Let's try again, sigh again, fly again to heaven. Baby, see, it's ABC. I love you and you love me. I know, no, no, what a bo, bo, bo should do, baby. So don't say it won't come true, baby. My heart begins to hum, dum de dum de dum dum dum. So do what you done before.
Sweet, sweet tasted before, cannot stand an encore. You know that a miss who always gets a kiss would soon become a bore.
I can't see that at all. True love never should pall.
I was only teasing. What you did was pleasing. Do what you done before. Maybe do what I do adore. Baby, let's try again, sigh again, fly again to heaven. Baby, see, I love you and you love me.
You dear, little dear, come here, snappy. And see, little me, make you happy. So do what you done before.
Thank you very much. As I said before, we're very glad that you're here to help celebrate our 25th anniversary. Also like to thank the generosity of Johnny Holiday, who's right over here, Johnny Holiday, who has forked over a pretty penny for our meals. So thank you so very much. I believe our desserts are waiting for us at the during the break. So don't talk to us until we have our tiramisu. So thank you very much, Johnny. We also have some special guests here as well. We also have tap dancer extraordinaire, Rusty Frank, right over there. Hello, Rusty. We also have a wonderful singer, Todd Murray, is in the house as well, Todd Murray. And also the lovely and talented Christine Nelson is here. And of course, I would be totally in the doghouse if I not mention my beautiful wife, Adrian, who is here, flew down from Sacramento. We have no idea where our son is right now, but I'm sure he's fine. All right. Oh, there you go. Gee, thanks, kid. All right. Now, as I mentioned, our other musician, Zero, who was here with the band on the very first concert back in 1994. He is now the trumpet specialist with Jonathan Stout in the Campus Five. Please welcome to the stage, Mr. Jim Ziegler.
Hello, sir. Thanks.
And sir, what will you be singing with us this evening?
Well, sir, I think we're gonna start out with Deep Elm.
That's right, Deep Elm. And that was a song by recorded by Herb Wiedoff.
Oh, there you go.
And his Cinderella Roof Ballroom, which was here in downtown L.A. In case you wanted to know where the Cinderella Roof Ballroom was, it was on the corner where the bank building is right now. So that's where you would go to downtown. And Herb Wiedoff was there for about 3 or 4 years. And this is one of his hit songs.
Wait.
Now we're going to have Jim Ziegler sing it for us. So Let me get out of your way.
Okay. Should I use this one on the right? This one's good?
Yes.
This is good.
So he's going to play the solo that's...
No. He's got...
Oh,
that's
he's
the
okay.
Yeah.
Right. Never mind.
Yeah, you do, yeah. Yeah, that's a knowledge.
Take it, ladies and
gentlemen. You got to do something.
Thank you very much. That was Deep Elm with one of those recordings that bands used to do that end nowhere. And so
I love
those type of endings. Well, Jim's here. He's going to sing for you another song. This was written by the great Benny Carter called The Goodbye Blues. I had the honor of meeting Benny Carter back in the early 2000s, and I played him one of our CDs, and he said, "Where did you get all those old guys?" And I said, "No, we're all in our 30s. Good times. Anyway, he was very impressed with the band. And anyway, so in his honor, we're going to play for you one of his recordings or one of his arrangements. And Jim is going to sing and play the solo. Here we go with the Goodbye Blues.
I'm not going to take them all.
I'm not taking everyone's soul.
Is that a trumpet?
Is that it?
Yeah, that's all. From now tonight, I'm just going to do the trumpet soul. I'm going to give you all a break. All right. Okay? Thank you.
He'll be back later in the evening. I want to acknowledge some other members of our group. On the tenor sax solo, we had Phil Krawczak on tenor sax. On the trombone back there, Jim McMillan. Did a really great job. And on that day, back in November of 1994, we had some great players that were with us. We had John Reynolds was there with Larry Wright, the great drummer. Larry Wright, the other folks, Eric Miller, Ron Singer. And I met a lot of these people through the association of a band leader that most of us all started with, and that is the great Johnny Crawford. And it was actually, if we're talking about anniversaries, it was actually for me this month, 25 years ago, that I started playing for him at the Atlas Bar and Grill. Any of you guys remember the Atlas Bar and Grill? Yes. It was housed in the Wiltern Theater building. It was a wonderful place. We played there every Thursday night. I was with them there for a year. And then after a while, I said, hey, I can run a band. I've got no disposable income. Yeah, sure. Okay, anyway. So, this past week, the Art Directors Guild Awards, they honored Johnny with his a tribute to him. He's no longer able to lead a band. He has some health issues. But we're going to play for you one of my favorite songs that I used to play. We used to play when he was a band leader. We're going to have Damon sing it for you. It's from 1930, a Maurice Chevalier tune called Sweeping the Clouds Away.
Hoping happiness will come. That's not the way. It doesn't pay. If you want happiness, just help yourself to some. Why don't you try to take life like I do? Let the whole world sigh or cry. I'll be high in the sky, up on top of a rainbow, sweeping the clouds away. I don't care what's down below. Let it rain, let it snow. I'll be up on a rainbow, sweeping the clouds away. I have learned life's lesson. Fighters who always win are those who can take it right on the chin and grin. And so I shout to everyone, find your place in the sun, up on top of a rainbow, sweeping the clouds away.
Gentlemen, and best wishes to Johnny Crawford. And now we're going to do a song for you that was a Latin song that was recorded by Gus Arnheim and his Coconut Grove Orchestra. Coconut Grove, of course, the Ambassador, the late great Ambassador Hotel on Wilshire Boulevard. And Gus was the band leader of the nightclub band there from 1928 to about 1931. And he was also a composer, and he recorded, I don't think he recorded, composed this song, but he recorded it for sure, and we're going to play it for you, She Went Havana. We're going to have Damon sing it for you.
Went to Weimar from Susquehanna. She went to Weimar and I'm all aflame. Her folks are Cuban. Her name is Reuben. Or is it Lubin? Say, what's in a name? Now I taught her that lingo from the land of sugar cane. But now my little gringo I will never see again. She went to Weimar, she changed her manner. She's called Manana. Oh boy, what a day.
Ladies and gentlemen, She Went Havana, recorded by Gus Arnheim and his orchestra. We're gonna skip Avalon Town and go to Moaning Low.
Yes. Moaning Low.
We're gonna bring Karen Morrison to the microphone again to sing a song recorded by, thank you, Annette Henshaw from 1929, 90 years ago. It's a great song called Moaning Low.
Feel too bad. I'm feeling mighty sad. pass me by. If he goes, hurt he'll be. He's a guy the man needs, a kind of woman like me. Don't know any reason why he treats me so poorly. What have I gone and done? Makes my troubles double with his worries when surely I ain't deserving of none. Moaning low, my sweet man, he's gonna go. When he goes, oh Lordy, he's the kind of man needs a kind of woman like me.
Thank you very much. Kevin's going to come back and now sing for you a song recorded by Lee Morse from 1930. It's called "Tain't No Sin to Take Off Your Skin and Dance Around on Your Bones." You imagine it. Okay.
Take off lots of fat, but I'm no friend of dancing when it's hot. So if you are a dancing fool who loves to dance but can't keep cool, bear in mind the idea that I've got. When it gets too hot for comfort and you can't get ice cream cones, tain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your bones. When the lazy the music soft their moans, tain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your bones. Polar bears aren't green up in Greenland. They got the right idea. They think it's great to refrigerate while we all cremate down here. Just be like those bamboo babies in the tropic island zone. Tain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your bones. When you're calling up your sweetie in those hothouse telephones, tain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your bones. When you're on a crowded dance floor near those red hot saxophones, tain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your bones. Take a look at the girls while they're dancing. Notice the way they're dressed. They wear silken clothes without any hose, and nobody knows the rest. No more singing with those television phones. Ain't no sin to take off your skin and dance around in your phone.
One more number for the set, and then we're going to move into the repertoire of our 1930s, which we were known for quite a while. I think we went from 1920 to 1936, and that's it. Wild times have changed. But anyway, but for tonight, we'll go to 1936, something like that. I don't know why. I know. And I know why. Oh, I know. Stop it. All right, we're going to finish off with a tune by Abe Lyman and his Californians. This is from 1926. This is called Shake That Thing.
Thank you.
very much, folks. Shake that thing, whatever that thing is. We'll be back after a brief intermission. Thank you.
Say, folks, it's here one more time for Mora's Modern Rhythmists. Featuring Mr. Mora Modern, a very modern man. Say, Mr. Modern, Mr. Mora Modern, Dean Mora. Look, we have birthdays.
We do. We have Don and Bertram.
Happy birthday. Now, speaking of birthdays, here's someone that has absolutely nothing to do with the birthday. I'd like to have someone come up and say hello to you, Mr. Johnny Holiday. Johnny Holiday? Johnny Holiday? Here's Johnny Holiday.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I know many of you may not know this, but when I first started in this business, our sponsor was Geritol, and I worked for a band leader who'd been around since the 30s. And tonight, I feel like the Geritol sign should be hanging right behind us, because Dean Mora, probably more than Mr. Welk or Guy Lombardo, has worked longer than any other band leader consistently for 25 years, which is pretty amazing in this industry. And it has been my honor and my pleasure to have this man write my charts, get together the best musicians in the world who work with me here, and we'll be working together again elsewhere. And I just want to congratulate him, because let me tell you, this is a lot of work. And if you've been in the business as long as I have, 49 years, singing all over the United States and Europe, there aren't a lot of people that can say, I've been doing this for 25 years. He is an amazing man, as are the musicians here. And I want to say to you, Dean, I hope I'll be around for your 50th. And thanks to latex, polyester, and Cyclon B, I may very well be here. So Dean, your wife and I are leaving now, but I want to congratulate you on 25 years. And Mr. DeMille, thank you for keeping music alive in Los Angeles.
And we'll see you in March 16th, Johnny Holiday Show. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Holiday appears courtesy of Forest Lawn Mortuaries. Mention Johnny Holiday's name, get half off special this week only. And Mr. Mora?
Yes, sir.
We started back in 1897.
1897, exactly.
Where I presented a show at the Orpheum Theater just down on 9th Street. Vaudeville Comes Home was the show, and Dean was providing the orchestra. Our special guest that night was Mr. Billy Barty.
Yes, remember Billy? Well,
a big man. A little stature, but he was swell, wasn't he?
He was a great guy.
And that's the last time I worked with Dean. This is the next time. It's been 25
Absolutely,
years since we've worked together.
Yes.
It only feels that way now. It's 25 years.
Exactly.
And say, Dean, thanks again for bringing the guys out. And you're going to come back for another set.
Well, thanks for having us here, and we hope you continue doing these shows for a long time after.
At least until next week, they're tearing it down for a parking lot. But other than that, we're in good shape.
Great.
Dean Mora, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, folks. See you soon.
Hello again, ladies and gentlemen. This is Maxwell DeMille talking here at the fabulous Cicada Club in beautiful downtown Los Angeles, California. Thank you, Mr. Mora. I'd like to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we're broadcasting live around the world and across the nation by means of electronic television. How does it work? It's technically unexplainable, but you can watch it on the YouTube or on the Facebook. Go to the Facebook and look up Cicada Club and Restaurant, and you'll be able to see tonight's festivities. During the band break, we've been playing selections from Mr. Mora's past recordings. That last one you heard was called My Favorite Band, where Mr. Mora sings the vocals. No comment, okay. That was from his very first recording called My Favorite Band. And now, My Favorite Band continues. Let's have a big round of applause celebrating 25 big boffo years. Here's the next 1 year. If you can make it the next one, you can get another 24 out of it. All you need is one more. Please welcome once again, Mora's Modern Rhythmists.
Thank you, Mr. DeMille. Yes, sir, it has been 25 boffo years, although a couple of them were blotto years, but that's another story. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we are streaming live throughout the world, and I'd like to put a special shout out to my friends out in Sacramento, the River City Corral, and also the folks who are rehearsing a production of 42nd Street at the Woodland Opera House. I hope you're listening, and if you are listening, the catchphrase next time you see me is, the avocados are growing in Vacaville. The avocados are growing in Vacaville. So, come up to me when I get up there, and I'll know that you listened to me. All right, so in honor of those folks, those kids out there in Woodland, we will play for you the original dance band version of 42nd Street from the year 1933. Thank you, 42nd Street. One more time. With feeling. Yeah, we do 43rd Street instead. All righty, and now it's time to, it's time to bring back. Now it's time to bring back Jim Ziegler and a song that he made very popular when he was with a band. And this is the Jimmy Lunsford arrangement of Four or Five Times.
Thank you.
It always makes people jump. All right, now he's going to be joined on the microphone by Kara Morrison in a song from 1936 called The Mayor of Alabama.
That's right.
No, you ain't.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not. 25 years, you're not.
I want to tell you. I swung the election.
I swung the election. Awesome.
Gerrymandered. Yes, I did.
He'll be back later. He guarantees it. All right. Yeah, I forgot to mention I need to thank a lot of the members here who are working very hard to make sure your evening is enjoyable, and I've enjoyed their company for 25-ish years. And so I'd like to acknowledge the people in the back. We have Mr. Jonathan Dane and Roy Wiegand and Jim McMillan in the brass section. And I've mentioned before on tenor sax, Phil Krawczyk on tenor sax. Musician Zero, Jeff Newdell. Musician Zero. That didn't sound good, but you know. But anyway, sorry about that. And also, on the third alto, I guess Musician One, you joined, what, 95, 96, something like that. When he was a child, once again, Matt Germain on the alto sax. This gentleman started with us back in, I think, 1995 on the violin. That's the first time in about 10 years you've been with us. Please welcome back Terry Glennie. And on the drums way back there in Assorted Noises, Mr. Ray Frisbee. And I think you started with us when we were playing at the Derby back in the 2000s, I think, on guitar and banjo, Mr. Denny Hardwick. And also this gentleman, multi-talented, multi-instrumentalist on tuba, trombone, and that thing there. We have Mr. Toby Holmes. And of course, also please thank our choral department, Kara Morrison and Damon Kirsch. And there are some folks that we usually have that we couldn't make it with us because of the space and stuff like that. We'd like to thank Bill Wilson and Jim Jenikin and Martin Matthews and Bill Barrett. And also acknowledge some of the people who have passed on, Bobby Korda and Rich Berkeley, who are no longer with us on this earth. So we thank all of them for their service here too with Mora's Modern Rhythms. Oh, yes, and Jack. Jack LeCompte, the great Jack LeCompte. We miss him so much. Yes. Anyway, okay, let's continue here with Care's very first song singing with us. This was the great classic, Moonglow.
Thank you.
So now when there's moonlight, where are you? I always remember that moon you gave you.
Thank you, Kerr. And now here's a song that's going to go out to Mr. Walter Nelson, who's feeling a little down, a little bit of, just a little bit of pneumonia, just nothing serious, just pneumonia. Anyway, here's a song that he and his wife always request. It's by Jose Norman from 1936, Cuban Pete. Care? What's next? All right, now Damon Kirsch is going to sing for you a song from 1934. This was originally recorded by Hal Kemp and his orchestra. This is Blue Moon.
Suddenly appeared before me, the only one my arms would ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, "Please adore me." And when I looked, the moon had turned to gold. Blue moon, now I'm no longer alone. Without a dream in my heart, without a love of my
Damon, and now we're going to do a song for you that was recorded by the Dorsey Brothers before they split up. Jimmy and Tommy, this is one of their recordings from 1935. They recorded it and was promptly banned from the airwaves. You'll soon find out why. This is Annie's Cousin Fanny. We're going to feature Care. That's right. Care Morrison. and Jim Singleton. Well, these 25 years, they really take their toll on you, don't you?
Such a wonderful pal. She likes me, and I go for Annie's cousin Fanny. Every night at 7, I call at her door. Annie doesn't live there anymore. But I don't care, 'cause I go for Annie's cousin Fanny. Her lips are like honey, kisses like wine. She saves them all for me. She's not like her cousin, she's one in a dozen. Fanny's ruined Annie's popularity. She always stays at home and she answers the bell. She tells all the others to go to, well, WC. Why I go for Annie's cousin Fanny.
That's right. Now look out now. Annie changed her address, took her name off the door. Now I don't know why she didn't do that before. She folded up her coat and took her hat off the shelf. Now I can have my Fanny all to myself.
I go Fanny. I go Fanny, Annie's cousin Fanny, it's a girl for me.
That's right.
A gentleman with a top hat asked Annie for a date.
That's right.
He said, I'll bring a friend for Fanny, meet us at 8.
Don't be late.
They drove out in the woods where they could be alone. And Annie's cousin Fanny is still walking home.
I like Fanny. I like Fanny.
Well, Annie and Fanny were friends long ago. And everywhere that Annie went, Fanny would go. But Annie's boyfriend Harvey said, give us a break. Tried to shake Fanny, but Fanny wouldn't shake.
Oh, you could shake Fanny, could shake Fanny, could shake Fanny, she go too. Couldn't shake Fanny, could shake Fanny, could shake Fanny.
What to do? Well, here's the thing that Fanny did will give you a laugh. Fanny built a house, but it didn't have a bath.
Oh, my goodness.
So Annie called around one day, and she said to Fanny, that's a very clever house, my dear. It's so uncanny.
I like Fanny, I got Fanny, and it's uncanny.
Annie's cousin Fanny is a sweetie of mine.
That's right.
She stays at home and waits for me all the
every
time.
Every night.
You may know some girls in Annie that are divine, but you never saw a Fanny half as pretty as mine.
Annie's cousin Fanny is a sweetie of mine.
Why, thank you, folks. Thank you. Thank you, Jim Singler. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. Now, people say, but where's Cole Porter? Well, here he is, folks. of course you said that. So here we are with Karen Damon singing for you. It's D-Lovely.
Night is young, the skies are clear, and if you want to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's still lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, 'cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's still lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature murmuring low, let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's delimit, it's deluxe, it's delovely.
Marches on, and soon it's plain. You won my heart, and I've lost my brain. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. Life seems so sweet that we decide it's in the bag to get unified. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. See the crowd at the church. See the proud parson propped on his perch. Hear the sweet of the organ sealing our doom. There goes the groom. Boom! How they cheer and how they smile as we go galloping down the aisle.
It's to blind dear.
It's to be near.
It's to wunderbar.
It's to victory.
It's to volum. It's to vimit. It's to voice. It's to lovely.
Thank you very much. Are you guys okay there? Hey, thank you. All right, now David's going to sing a song for you. People ask, do you play any Frank Sinatra? Well, here's our one Frank Sinatra song. And this is a hit he made with Harry James and his orchestra from 1939. It's All or Nothing at All.
Something that might have been. No, I'd rather have nothing at all or nothing at all. If it's love, why begin and cry for something that might have been? No, I'd rather have nothing at all. Oh, please don't bring your lips so close to my cheek. Don't cry. Kiss in your eyes and the smile on your cheeks seem to me, and my heart may grow dizzy and fall. And if
I felt under the spell of your call. I would be caught in the undertow. And so you see, I've got to say no, no.
You got to sing another song. There's a song recorded by Fletcher Henderson, and the chart was originally done by our very dear friend, the late great Spud Murphy, and it's called Do You or Don't You Want Me?
I'm sorry.
Love Me. It's a totally different song.
Don't you love me? Will you or won't you say you're mine? Why must we keep on wasting time when there's lots to do for me and you when we're a loving couple? Do you or don't you want me? In all my dreams you're haunting me. Why must you keep on taunting me with your yes and no and no and yes? You never can make your mind up, oh. You've got me pacing to and fro, oh. You've got me chasing shadows on the curtain because you can never be certain. Do you or don't you love me? Will you or won't you say you're mine? Why must we keep on wasting time? Honey, do you or don't you? Will you or won't you say that you're gonna be mine?
Thank you, folks. We're now going to play for you the song that was our closing theme, our opening and closing theme at our Monday night shows at the late, great Derby nightclub in Los Feliz. We're there for 3 years, the Monday night house band. And here is our theme song from that time. This is from, it's actually the theme song for the Casa Loma Orchestra. This is Smoke Rings, and Kara's going to sing it for you. Thanks, Kara. Thank you. That was nice. What a band! All right, so we're gonna do Jitterbug, and then finish off with Rhythmists. So we're gonna skip this special.
Oh, okay.
It's a big barn burner.
I know. Well, okay. If you want to do it, we'll do it. Okay. All right. So Jitterbug. All right, fine, jeez. Okay, how quickly they turn on you. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna have Kara sing for you a song that was cut from the motion picture, The Wizard of Oz. Producers felt it was too contemporary. Sure, glad they don't do that these days. Anyway, This tune is called The Jitterbug. All right, folks, we have one more for you. We so very much thank you for coming down and celebrating the 25th anniversary of Mora's Modern Rhythmists. And of course, we'll be back around with different names, the Dean Moranis Orchestra, the Avalon Ball Orchestra, the Queen Mary Dance Orchestra, the Latin Airs, the Fort MacArthur Office. Anyway, we'll be back. So hope to see you again very soon. There is news that we may be doing the Halloween show in October, and this will be, because it will be the 90th anniversary of the stock market crash, yay, we're going to make it a great Gatsby night, all 1920s music on Halloween. So if you can show up in your finest outfit like that, it'll be great. So anyway, we're going to finish off this evening again with the Big John Special.
to Mora's Modern Rhythmists here at the Cicada Club with their 25th anniversary show. We hope you've enjoyed your night, and we hope to see you again very soon. But for now, this is Maxwell DeMille. Wish you all the best of good luck, and good evening. Mr. Dean Mora. And the Modern Rhythmists, Kara Morrison and Damon Kirsch. The Condor Crew and the Redheaded Robin of Rhythm. And now the band wants to take a photograph. Very well. I'll step out and you can take the photograph. I don't want to hog up the spotlight. I'll hog the microphone.